Acid Raymond, President Obama's not gone yet. He's there for 3 weeks in January, not to mention all of December and now November. What do you think he should do? I mean, you're talking right now to his climate envoy. Well, to the climate envoy, the science envoy for the State Department.
Look, as we all recognize, the clock is ticking on humanity's ability to tackle the climate crisis and create a safer and more equal world for all of the world's citizens. And in that, President Obama can still make a big difference. He can raise the bar on climate action. First and foremost, today is a solidarity day with the Native American people in Standing Rock. He could send a powerful signal saying, I stand with those people. I stand with ordinary people trying to protect their water, their air and their land. That would be a positive signal. The United States has really contributed very little to these negotiations. In its fund for the Green Climate Fund, which helps the poorer people be able to adapt to the floods and the droughts that are happening all around the world, the United States currently is given $500 million. It still owes $2.5 billion. He could make sure that that check is delivered before he leaves.
Okay. What about that, Daniel Cameron?
I think those are very good points. So we know that the cost of climate change is high on a security basis, on a local basis, and fulfilling as many of these obligations as possible while in office makes a lot of sense. For not only the humanitarian reasons, but it's actually good business. It promotes the kind of companies, the kind of entrepreneurs that we think are pro-equality, not just pro-profits.
Very quickly, Daniel Cameron, right now, although the policy in the U.S. is leading away from coal, talk about what's happening right now in Kosovo, an issue you know well. You've got like 30 seconds. Yeah.
Kosovo's a tough case because there's a small coal plant in country. It's the dirtiest in Europe. The U.S. committed earlier this year to not funding overseas coal. It's a country where the wind and geothermal resources are enough, and yet study after study from the outside has said, go with the clean energy, and yet we've seen no switch in position from the World Bank. We haven't seen a pullback from the U.S. position. It's the kind of test bed where you want to see clean energy lead, not lag.
Will you be telling John Kerry this today?
I absolutely will.
Final comment, Acid Raymond, 30 seconds.
Well, Friends of the Earth all over the world is committed to building the people power, the power of the movements to be able to hold all of our governments accountable. We know here government leaders have an opportunity now to send a very positive signal. They can increase their pre-2020 emission targets. They can put us on the pathway to keep under 1.5. And they can provide the finance of poorer countries to be able to grow cleanly and have a hope of a dignified life. We know that politics is not just in those buildings. Politics is about ordinary people uniting together and forcing change. We've done it before, and we will do it again.
Acid Raymond is the spokesperson for Friends of the Earth International based in Britain. Daniel Cameron, the science envoy for the U.S. State Department, professor of energy at University of California, Berkeley. This is Democracy Now! When we come back,